Boxing Eagle here. If you like this video, make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon on the top of your screen to get notified when the latest new content drops. One. What up, fight world? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button. Also subscribe to the channel for the latest and greatest in boxing. If you want to become part of the gang, hit the bell icon. Shout out to the super chats, channel donations, and the Patreon family. We working, y'all holding it down. Now, October 14th, it goes down. Shout out to Al Haymon, Steven Espinoza, Showtime, because they put together a junior middleweight 154-pound triple header on Showtime. That from top to bottom, it's a very solid card as far as what they're televising. You have pretty much everybody who has a name at 154. And before, in previous videos, I was saying minus Demetrius Andrade, but Andrade just announced, it's on the website, make sure you guys check that article out, boxingego.com. He announced he's moving up to middleweight. So he's no longer, at the moment, going to be considered a junior middleweight. It looks like he's testing the waters, and if he likes it up there, he'll probably stay up there, right? So this is the who's who of the division. And you have the main event, Edislandi Lada, who arguably shouldn't have any losses. Some people thought he beat Canelo. He definitely beat Paul Williams and got robbed, right? Versus an undefeated Terrell Gouchee, who's an Olympian, represented the United States of America, and has an amateur background. You have the co-main event, which is the nature of this video. Undefeated Jermell Charlo versus an undefeated hotshot up-and-comer, Erickson Hammer Lubin, who's getting a lot of praise. He's had some good PBC performances, but he hasn't stepped up to the caliber of anybody like a Charlo. So this is going to be a defining fight for him to see if he can put up or shut up. And then you also have Jared Swift Hurd versus Austin Trout. Austin Trout, very game. He has losses. He's lost to Canelo, got knocked down. Lost to Edison Lada, got knocked down. But he went the distance. He went the distance with Jermell Charlo. I covered that fight. Jermall Charlo. And Jermall Charlo's looked way bigger than him. And he's somebody who's had good stoppages since then. Like the Julian Williams J-Rock knockout, where he hurt Julian in early with the jab. And then he finished him off later with the uppercut. And then he moved up to middleweight and stopped Jorge Sebastian Hyland. So anyway you slice it, this is the who's who of the division. Canelo's no longer there. Jermall's no longer there. Boo Boo Andrade is looking like he's moving up, which means his belt that he beat Jack Kukulé for, that will probably become available. So overall, a great card. Now, the link is in the description. It is a Showtime clip. I posted it on my Instagram, but make sure you guys check it out. Erickson Hammer Lubin, he just says straight out, Brian Custer's like, what makes you feel like you could beat Jermell Charlo? Why are you different? Why are you a different opponent for him? And he tells you there's no lack of confidence. He doesn't hesitate. Erickson Lubin says he ain't beat nobody. As far as I'm concerned, he's a paper champion. He fought for a vacant belt. And the two people that he got the title for or defended his title against, they're nothing like me. And they weren't respected names in the division. He said John Jackson and Charles Hatley. He said, so he just hasn't fought no one that's up to speed, that brings what I bring, probably the power, southpaw, amateur experience, stuff like that. So he just straight up called him a paper champion. So big words from Erickson Lubin. Again, you guys can check the clip on my Instagram. I've linked to it in the description. This excites me, man. Like this, because when you have two undefeated fighters, undoubtedly, it's harder to take the other person's O. So Charlo, even if he wins, he's probably gonna have to work for it, because this confidence from Lubin, it doesn't appear fake. It seems like he really means it. Now, I don't know. I'm kind of leaning towards Charlo, really off of experience, and Lubin's young, but I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Anytime you have this type of confidence, he does have some power. He's a southpaw, and it's going to be an interesting fight. So he definitely has a shot. Definitely a pick 'em fight. I see a lot of people rocking with Lubin. I just haven't seen him step up. That's the only thing I disagree. I don't think Charles Hatley and John Jackson, they weren't like bottom feeders, you know what I mean, like bottom dweller type of competition. You could say they're not Demetrius Andrade, but I thought those are good wins. And like I said, I was at Jermall and Jermell's fight on Showtime with Edislani Lada, and Jermell was getting outboxed by John Jackson. So the fact that he was getting outboxed and was able to turn it around and create the stoppage, that was impressive to me, you know what I mean? And he switched some things up with his training and trainer. He's with Errol Spence Jr.'s trainer, Derek James. He spars a lot with Errol Spence. So just kind of a different mindset. Maybe he switched some things with his lifestyle. So all in all, it's a good fight, man. I just want to see it. I don't really care who wins, but I like the confidence. I will say that. Other thing is Erickson the Hammer Lubin. He signed a deal with Lil Wayne. We are not the same. I am a mark. Like Gonzalez, Young Wallace. Right? Lil Wayne of hip hop fame, I guess, has some kind of sports agency, and they picked up Erickson Lubin. So they're going to represent him in some capacity. I think he's still with Al Haymon. So I don't know exactly what they're there to do. Maybe just give him promotion. I don't know. But that has to be a confidence builder too. You know what I mean? That you're being recognized and endorsed by somebody else who's starting up a sports agency, and they want you to be one of the faces of it. So between that, I don't know. Just Lubin sounds confident. There's no other way to put it. He sounds confident. I'm sure Jermell Charlo is confident. And like I said, when two fighters are undefeated, I mean, something's got to give. Somebody's O has to go, unless it's a Canelo Triple G where it's a draw. And that doesn't sound like this is a drawish type of fight. So shout out to Showtime for just really putting together a very solid card. And this is what I want to hear. I mean, two fighter, two undefeated guys. I mean, they're supposed to go at each other's neck. And then ultimately, we'll see who makes good with their promises. But I like what I'm seeing from Lubin in this Showtime interview. Drop your thoughts in the comment section. Make sure you smash the like button as always. Hate, comment, and subscribe. Till next video, it's Ego sending off. So if you enjoyed this video and want more content like this on the channel, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal donate button or the YouTube support button. And you can donate any amount that you feel is equivalent to the value of this video. Much more to come. Thank you guys for your support. Boxing Ego, the future of boxing.